I was born in Arkansas, in the same bed that I was made. My mother loves to tell me all about that, and her midwife, Miss Goodall. Well, I was raised on the buffalo gloves, I swear, the bottom of my feet are proud and tough. And I moved to Memphis when I was 13. I was not ready for the big city wasteland. Oh, mama, I'm going outside for Seattle. Rocky Top Mountains and Ruby Creek, yeah, they help me keep my peace and state of mind intact to the final things in life. We work all day like damned old dogs. We get home and chill on sawed off logs, from porch picking, lumbly peg too, by the summer night light of the moon. Oh, mama, I'm going outside for Seattle.
There you go.
That's a short version. Woo-hoo. I've been here a long time.
So soon on the Dunbar end,
everyone sang.
When strangers became your new best friends,
everyone sang.
It was Armistice Day and peace broke out,
everyone sang.
Sometimes a melody is louder than a shout,
everyone sang.
Somebody struck up a song. We didn't know the words, but still we sang along. Just our voices, that's all. Everywhere a concert hall, voices, that's all. Lullaby and call. Chucking out time at the bar on the corner. From the Albion taproom to California,
everyone sang.
In the olden days before they put in a jukebox,
everyone sang.
Please to put a penny in the old man's voice box,
everyone sang.
Somebody struck up a song. We didn't know the words, but still we sang along. Just our voices, that's all. Everywhere a concert hall, voices, that's all. Lullaby and call. In the middle of a demonstration,
everyone sang.
All power to imagination,
everyone sang.
Your song, it sounds a whole lot better,
everyone sang.
When everyone sings that song together,
everyone sang.
Somebody struck up a song. We didn't know the words, but still we sang along.
Just our voices, that's all. Everywhere a concert hall, voices, that's all. Lullaby and call. Just our voices, that's all. Everywhere a concert hall, voices, that's all. Lullaby and call, just our voices, that's all.
Bear Ubu, your murderous plot is accomplished. King Venceslas is dead. but you bungled the attack. Mm-hmm. Yes, yes, you did. He shouted at you and you ran away. You left the malcontents to stamp the life out of him. Meanwhile, the queen escaped with Prince Buggerlass. No good shall come of this. Still, you occupy the royal palace in Warsaw for now. Your fat wife has some advice for you. Listen to her.
Well, you've killed King Venceslas. What a shambles of a day. And you've flattened nearly all his family in your haste to run away from the fight. But you wear the crown of Poland.
Long live Peru.
You wear the big sombrero.
Long live Peru.
And now it is the time to play the part of Nero.
What? Do you want to ruin me for these pig-blooded buffoons that I rule?
Don't you see? The people are waiting for the gift of the joyous succession.
If you don't hand over some meat and gold, you'll be thrown out on your big ass in a few hours.
Meat, yes, gold, no. Kill a few old donkeys, it's good enough for ass it is.
If you're stupid with your hand up, they'll moan about the taxes.
Is that true?
Of course it is.
Then I agree to everything.
Captain Ordura go out onto a balcony overlooking the courtyard of the palace, which is full of people. Tokens, forms, pamphlets, lottery tickets, and small pieces of official-looking paper into the crowd.
Promise that you'll pay the taxes.
Yes, we will.
Promise that you'll pay the taxes.
Yes, we will.
Look, Merubu, how they scramble all over each other, grabbing up everything in sight.
Oh, it's horrible. Ooh, there's one with his skull split open.
What a wonderful sight. Bring me more.
Let's get them to race each other.
What a splendid idea.
I agree to everything.
I agree to everything. I agree to everything.
Ridiculous, so ridiculous. living in a nutshell of the sandstorm-ito, with our tails between our teeth, among the others gone astray, watching all the idiots who throw it all away. Now if you sit down and let the world move along, find a way to see what's really going on, and you stand up to be diligent and strong. In a world gone mad for so long, it's ridiculous, ridiculous, so ridiculous, it's ridiculous. And the kind ones, and the struggle for the goal, with their tails between their teeth, among the others gone astray, acting just like idiots, throw it all away. Now if you sit down and let the world move along, find a way to see what's really going on, and you stand up to be diligent and strong. In a world gone mad for so long, you got to sit down and let the world move along, find a way to see what's really going on, and you stand up to be diligent and strong. You know we'll go mad for so long, it's ridiculous, ridiculous, so ridiculous, ridiculous, it's ridiculous, preposterous, so ridiculous, it's ridiculous.
It's the way. so slow. Alarm clocks ring rather than talk radio.
Soon on the Dunbar end,
everyone sang.
When strangers became your new best friends,
everyone sang.
It was Armistice Day and peace broke out,
everyone sang.
Sometimes a melody is louder than a shout,
everyone sang.
Somebody struck up a song. We didn't know the words, but still we sang along.
Just our voices, that's all. Everywhere a concert hall, voices, that's all. Lullaby and call.
Chucking out time at the bar on the corner,
sang.
From the Albion taproom to California,
everyone sang.
In the olden days before they put in a jukebox,
everyone sang.
Please to put a penny in the old man's voice box,
everyone sang.
Somebody struck up a song. We didn't know the words, but still we sang along.
Just our voices, that's all. Everywhere a concert hall, voices, that's all. Lullaby and
in the middle of a demonstration,
everyone sang.
All power to imagination,
everyone sang.
Your song, it sounds a whole lot better,
everyone sang.
When everyone sings that song together,
everyone sang.
Somebody struck up a song. We didn't know the words, but still we sang along.
Just our voices, that's all. Everywhere a concert hall, voices, that's all. Lullaby and call. Just our voices, that's all. just our voices, that's all.
Pere Ubu, your murderous plot is accomplished. King Venceslas is dead. But you bungled the attack. Mm-hmm. Yes, yes, you did. He shouted at you and you ran away. You left the malcontents to stamp the life out of him. Meanwhile, the queen escaped with Prince Bugarlass. No good shall come of this. Still, you occupy the royal palace in Warsaw for now. Your fat wife has some advice for you. Listen to her.
Well, you've killed King Venceslas. What a shambles of a day. And you flattened nearly all his family in your haste to run away from the fight. But you wear the crown of Poland.
Long live Peru.
You wear the big sombrero.
Long live Peru.
Play the part of Nero.
What? Do you want to ruin me for these pig-bladded buffoons that I rule?
Don't you see? The people are waiting for the gift of the joyous succession.
If you don't hand over some meat and gold, you'll be thrown out on your big ass in a few hours.
Yes, gold, no. Kill a few old donkeys. It's good enough for asses.
Live your stupid with your hand up the moon about the taxes.
Is that true?
Of course it is.
Then I agree to everything.
Mayor and Pere Ubu and Captain Ordura go out onto a balcony overlooking the courtyard of the palace, which is full of people. Tokens, forms, pamphlets, lottery tickets, and small pieces of official-looking paper into the crowd.
Promise that you'll pay the taxes.
Yes, we will.
Promise that you'll pay the taxes.
Yes, we will.
Look, Mayor Ubu, how they scramble all over each other, grabbing up everything in sight.
Oh, it's horrible. Ooh, there's one with his skull split open.
What a wonderful sight. Bring me more.
Let's get them to race each other.
What a splendid idea.
I agree to everything.
I agree to everything. I agree to everything.
Going on, then you stand up to be done. It's ridiculous. Ridiculous. So ridiculous. Ridiculous.
If history had left us with no memory to hold, we'd be living in a nutshell of the same story told, with our tails between our teeth, among the others gone astray, watching all the idiots who throw it all away. Now if you sit down and let the world move along, find a way to see what's really going on. And you stand up to be diligent and strong. In a world gone mad for so long, it's ridiculous. Ridiculous. So ridiculous. It's ridiculous.
And the kind ones,
and the struggle for the goal,
with their tails between their teeth, among the others gone astray,
acting just like idiots, throw it all away.
Now if you sit down and let the world move along, find a way to see what's really going on. And you stand up to be diligent and strong.
In a world gone mad for so long, you got to sit down and let the world move along.
Find a way to see what's really going on. And you stand up to be diligent and strong.
You know we'll go mad for so long. It's ridiculous. Ridiculous. So ridiculous. Ridiculous. It's ridiculous. Preposterous. So ridiculous.
It's
ridiculous.
so slow. Alarm clocks ring rather than talk radio.
Soon on the Dunbar end,
everyone sang.
When strangers became your new best friends,
everyone sang.
It was Armistice Day and peace broke out,
everyone sang.
Sometimes a melody is louder than a shout,
everyone sang.
Somebody struck up a song. We didn't know the words, but still we sang along.
Just our voices, that's all. Everywhere a concert hall. Voices, that's all. Lullaby and call.
Chucking out time at the bar on the corner.
Sang.
From the Albion tap room to California,
everyone sang.
In the olden days before they put in a jukebox,
everyone sang.
Please to put a penny in the old man's voice box,
everyone sang.
Somebody struck up a song. We didn't know the words, but still we sang along.
Just our voices, that's all. Everywhere a concert hall. Voices, that's all. Lullaby and
in the middle of a demonstration,
everyone sang.
All power to imagination,
everyone sang.
Your song, it sounds a whole lot better,
everyone sang.
When everyone sings that song together,
everyone sang.
Somebody struck up a song. We didn't know the words, but still we sang along.
Just our voices, that's all. Everywhere a concert hall. Voices, that's all. Lullaby and call. Just our voices, that's all.
that's all.
Bear Ubu, your murderous plot is accomplished. King Venceslas is dead. But you bungled the attack. Mm-hmm. Yes, yes, you did. He shouted at you and you ran away. You left the malcontents to stamp the life out of him. Meanwhile, the queen escaped with Prince Buggerlass. No good shall come of this. Still, you occupy the royal palace in Warsaw for now. Your fat wife has some advice for you. Listen to her.
Well, you've killed King Venceslas. What a shambles of a day. And you flattened nearly all his family in your haste to run away from the fight. But you wear the crown of Poland.
Long live Peru.
You wear the big sombrero.
Long live Peru.
To play the part of Nero.
What? Do you want to ruin me for these pig-bladded buffoons that I rule?
Don't you see? The people are waiting for the gift of the joyous succession.
If you don't hand over some meat and gold, you'll be thrown out on your big ass in a few hours.
Yes, gold, no, kill a few old donkeys, it's good enough for asses.
If you're stupid with your hand up, they'll know about the taxes.
Is that true?
Of course it is.
Then I agree to everything.
Mayor and Pear Ubu and Captain Ordura go out onto a balcony overlooking the courtyard of the palace, which is full of people. Tokens, forms, pamphlets, lottery tickets, and small pieces of official-looking paper into the crowd.
Promise that you'll pay the taxes.
Yes, we will.
Promise that you'll pay the taxes.
Yes, we will.
Look, Merubu, how they scramble all over each other, grabbing up everything in sight.
Oh, it's horrible. Ooh, there's one with his skull split open.
What a wonderful sight. Bring me more.
Let's get them to race each other.
What a splendid idea.
I agree to everything.
I agree to everything. I agree to everything.
Going on, and you stand up to be diligent and strong in a world.
Escovito, with our tails between our teeth, among the others gone astray, watching all the idiots who throw it all in way. Now if you sit down and let the world move along, find a way to see what's really going on. And you stand up to be diligent and strong in a world gone mad for so long. It's ridiculous, ridiculous, so ridiculous. It's ridiculous. And the kind ones, and the struggle for the goal, with their tails between their teeth, among the others gone astray, acting just like idiots, throw it all in way. Now if you sit down and let the world move along, find a way to see what's really going on. If you stand up to be diligent and strong in a world gone mad for so long, you got to sit down and let the world move along. Find a way to see what's really going on. And you stand up to be diligent and strong. You know we'll go mad for so long. It's ridiculous, ridiculous, so ridiculous, ridiculous. It's ridiculous, preposterous, so ridiculous. It's ridiculous.
It's the way.
so slow. Alarm clocks ringing rather than talk radio.
Everyone sang.
All power to imagination.
Everyone sang.
Your song, it sounds a whole lot better.
Everyone sang.
When everyone sings that song together.
Everyone sang.
Somebody struck up a song. We didn't know the words, but still we sang along.
Just our voices, that's all. Everywhere a concert hall. Voices, that's all. Lullaby and call. Just our voices, that's all.
that's all.
Pere Ubu, your murderous plot is accomplished. King Venceslas is dead. But you bungled the attack. Mm-hmm. Yes, yes, you did. He shouted at you and you ran away. You left the malcontents to stamp the life out of him. Meanwhile, the queen escaped with Prince Buggerlass. No good shall come of this. Still, you occupy the royal palace in Warsaw for now. Your fat wife has some advice for you. Listen to her.
Well, you've killed King Venceslas. What a shambles of a day. And you flattened nearly all his family in your haste to run away from the fight. But you wear the crown of Poland.
Long live Peru.
You wear the big sombrero.
Long live Peru.
Play the part of Nero.
What? Do you want to ruin me for these pig-bladded buffoons that I rule?
Don't you see? The people are waiting for the gift of the joyous succession.
If you don't hand over some meat and gold, you'll be thrown out on your big ass in a few hours.
Eat yes, gold no. Kill a few old donkeys. Good enough for asses.
If you're stupid with your hand up, they'll know about the taxes.
Is that true?
Of course it is.
Then I agree to everything.
Mayor and Pere Ubu and Captain Ordura go out onto a balcony overlooking the courtyard of the palace, which is full of people. Tokens, forms, pamphlets, lottery tickets, and small pieces of official-looking paper into the crowd.
Promise that you'll pay the taxes.
Yes, we will.
Promise that you'll pay the taxes.
Yes, we will.
Look, Mayor Ubu, how they scramble all over each other, grabbing up everything in sight.
Oh, it's horrible. Ooh, there's one with his skull split open.
What a wonderful sight. Bring me more.
Let's get them to race each other.
What a splendid idea.
I agree to everything.
I agree to everything. I agree to everything.
Everything.